And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth. And he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon.
Right now, Pope Francis is calling on North and South Korea to avoid fruitless criticisms and shows of force, but North Korea clearly not listening. This is day one of the Pope's historic five-day trip to South Korea. The pontiff got attention when he jumped in the backseat of a compact Kia hatchback, a car many South Koreans say is far too humble for such an important person. David Lee Miller, very humble himself, is following the story from our newsroom. David Lee.
Ed, the Pope, who has dedicated his life to saving souls, is visiting the South Korean capital of Seoul to call for reconciliation between the North and South. History was made even before the Pope landed in Korea. For the first time ever, China agreed to open its airspace to a plane used by the Pope. The Vatican and China do not have diplomatic relations. The Pope used the occasion to send a goodwill message to China's leader. And coinciding with the Pope's arrival, North Korea, flexing its military muscle, fired several rockets into the sea. For the first time in his papacy, the Pope gave a public address in English rather than Italian or his native Spanish. He did so in deference to his hosts. Pope Francis, meeting with South Korea's president, described peace as not simply the absence of war, but the work of justice. He said the quest for peace between the two Koreas affects the stability of the world.
May all of us dedicate this day to peace, to praying for it, and deepening our resolve to achieve it.
North Korea turned down an invitation to take part in mass during the Pope's visit. Among those who greeted the Pope were relatives of those who died during the recent sinking of a South Korean ferry. The tragedy claimed more than 300 lives. Approximately 10% of Korea's 50 million population are Catholic. And on Saturday, he is scheduled to beatify 124 Koreans who died as martyrs in the 18th and the 19th century. During his trip, he will also attend festivities for Asian Youth Day. And now, about that compact Korean-made car that the Pope used after he landed, well, it reinforces his reputation as the so-called People's Pope. He has rejected the use of that bulletproof Popemobile that his predecessors had used. And this particular model car that he used today, it is called what else? The Seoul. Ed?
The Seoul. Love it. David Lee Miller, thank you for that.
Can't make